Today's guest is a multi-million pound businesswoman and the former wife of the most powerful man in the world now, President Donald Trump. Now, she's no stranger to loose women, but today, in a world exclusive, she's giving us her first interview since her ex-husband became the President of the United States. There she is, before we talk to Ivana Trump. Here she is, previously getting live and loose with us.
Please give a very warm welcome to Ivana Trump. We're often portrayed as being a gold digger.
I was married, definitely, to a wealthy man. But guess what? When I married this wealthy man, he was not wealthy at all.
What I do when I exercise, sometimes what I do, you take the breath, I go,
I'm working my butt off.
Don was visionary, and he still is. I was a manager. He would throw the project at me, and once it was run like a Swiss watch, he would throw me to another project.
I'm a girl which is sort of hard to get.
It takes me longer and longer every morning to look glamorous, as you can imagine.
The brains are important to me, not necessarily the looks. Somehow nice. Manage to have a looks and the brains.
Well, we were delighted to have her on the show then. We're always delighted to see her. And Ivana Trump, thank you so much for joining us today. It's the afternoon here, but earlier in the morning in New York. What time did you have to get up for us, Ivana, this morning?
Girls, I kill you. You own me. I had to get up at 4 o'clock in the morning, so I went to sleep. I took some sleeping pills. I went to sleep at 6 o'clock in the morning. That I would be able to get up at 4 and be nice and fresh and makeup and hair and all that stuff. So you girls, you own me.
Well, we thank you for doing that for us. And did you have a little gin and tonic or a glass of champagne before you went to bed last night?
I heard you talking about gin and tonic and vanilla, and you make me both thirsty and hungry. No, I had a glass of white wine last night.
Well, obviously, Ivana, since you've been on Loose Women, a lot has changed. And your former husband is now the President of the United States. When you watched that inauguration, did you have a moment thinking that could have been me or that should have been me, the First Lady?
I really don't like the politics that much. And I would do a great job in the White House, but it is not in my inspiration, because I'm in a stage of my life that I do what I want to do. I go wherever I want to go, with whomever I want to go to with, and I can afford it, thanks God. So I'm like to be free.
Can I just ask, actually, you're saying there about being free, but obviously because of your association to Donald, have you ever had to worry about your own security? Because, of course, he has a big security detail around him.
I am, and I'm very, very careful. And I have, when I go to some occasions, I do have a secret service, but I don't want them all around, because I live in Manhattan, in the best street on Manhattan, you know, between Fifth and Madison Avenue, and I just walk across the living room. I'm in the restaurant, and in last few months, we didn't have nothing to do and nowhere to go, so we stay sort of home.
But when you do go to public functions, obviously in normal times, you have secret service agents keeping an eye on you.
Yes, I did.
You were married to Donald Trump for 15 years. You had 3 children together. How proud of him were you when you saw him being sworn in?
Very, very proud. You know, he was my husband of 15 years. I wish him all the best. I see that he can do a great job. He is pro everything which I believe in.
How often do you speak to the president? How would you describe your relationship now? Could you pick up the phone and speak to him at any time?
I can speak to him anytime, but he's so busy and he's traveling so much that if I call his secretary, And I called him another day, and he was on the telephone. No, he was not on telephone. It was 9 o'clock in the morning, early. And he picked up my phone, and I said, Donald, what are you doing? And he said, I'm signing the checks. I said, oh. And he said, before I sign the check for $300,000, for $300 million, now I'm signing checks for $300 billion. You know, so it is a big difference and big responsibility.
Can I just ask you also, I mean, your divorce, when you got divorced way back, it was quite nasty, wasn't it? So how long has it taken for you two to become kind of friendly again?
Well, it took about 2 years until our prenuptial agreement was finalized and we split whatever we had to split. And then we talk about the kids. We had three wonderful kids to raise. I think Eric was at that time 4 and Ivanka was probably 6 and Donald Jr. was 12, something like that. So, you know, they needed partner, you know, who would look after them and guide them. And so after all that was solved, we became very good friends.
When you call, do you ever speak to Melania? Do you and she have any kind of relationship, a friendship?
No, I speak directly to Mr. President, and I don't get involved with the ex-wives and his private life. You know, we talk about our children. Sometimes we talk about the economics, but I don't give him really advice. Yeah. I just tell him what I feel it's right and what is wrong, and that is that. But we don't talk about the ex-wives.
And was it, so have you never met
wives?
Have you never met Melania?
I don't understand.
Have you, you've never met her then? You've never actually met Melania?
Yes, of course I did.
Do you think she's doing a good job?
Again, can you answer the question?
Do you think Melania is doing a good job as First Lady? She gets quite a lot of good positive publicity.
I am not sure. She's very quiet and she really doesn't go to too many places. She goes through stuff and she has to go, but she's quiet.
Well, Ivana, I have to ask you this question. So you've been divorced now for quite a long time. I myself am divorced and I am back on the market, Ivana. And I'm finding it very difficult. But there you are, the ex-wife of the president. How difficult is it for you to start dating again?
You know what? I'm very, very relaxed. Like I said, I can go anywhere I want alone. Mm. I can go with whomever I want for lunch or dinner. You know, I can do whatever I want to do, and thanks God, and I can afford it. Yeah. So I'm not really looking. I have a lot of friends which are companions, and I go with them for the lunches and the dinners, and now we don't have any balls or any of the opera or anything which I used to go to because we just don't have it because of the vaccine. But you know, I have a lot of friends, male friends, which are really friends. I'm really not looking for the companionship, yes, but not for relationship.
Yes, absolutely.
Just quickly, Ivana, it's a privilege to meet you. You've done an amazing job with your children, raising them. Just wondered, what do you think, could Ivanka be the next female president of the United States?
I tell you, I think she's in the White House every day. You know, she's next to the father every day. She knows all what is going around. I think she could be one day the first girl, a woman president, definitely. She's smart as hell. She's beautiful. She's occurrent. And how much more you can have?
Absolutely.
Well, you must be very proud of your children, and it's great that you have that relationship with your ex-husband again, that you can talk about your children. Ivana, thank you for getting up so early for us this morning. it's great for you to join us today, and we hope to see you again soon.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. You won't be forgotten. 4 o'clock in the morning. I get revenge on you, okay? I get revenge on you.
Okay.
I don't get mad. I get even.
Oh, now I'm frightened. Now I'm frightened. Thank you so much. You can go back and have a sleep now. Thank you so much.